Hello everybody, today we are going to discuss the next part of the chapter, Atoms, Molecules and Radicals, part 3. So, as we have discussed earlier, the conception of the radicals and the valency. So, let's recall that valency. What is the valency? Valency is the combining capacity of an element. Accordingly, that what the definition of the valency, according to the textbook, the valency of an element or of a radical can be defined as the number of hydrogen atoms that will combine with or displace one atom of that element or radical. Okay, let me discuss about this one. Take that example, HCl. This is hydrochloric acid. So, you see that the chlorine atom. So, one chlorine atom is attached with one hydrogen atom, and that's why the valency of chlorine is 1. Take the another example, water, H2O. Here also you see that one oxygen atom combines with two hydrogen atoms. Number of hydrogen atoms that is associated or attached with one atom. So, how many hydrogen atoms attached here with one oxygen atom? 2. So, the valency of oxygen is 2. This is the formula of ammonia, NH3. And it is very clear that one nitrogen atom attached with the 3 hydrogen atoms. So, the valency of nitrogen is 3. This is the formula of methane, CH4. Here, the one carbon atom attached with the 4 hydrogen atoms. So, the valency of valency of carbon is 4. So, from this example, it is clear that how many hydrogen atoms, number of hydrogen atoms attached with one atom or one radical of that particular compound. Now, think this example, Zn, that means zinc, when reacts with dilute sulfuric acid, it forms zinc sulfate and hydrogen gas. Now you see that one atom of zinc that actually displaces how many hydrogen atoms from here? 2. And this is an example of displacement reaction. So here the zinc displaces 2 atoms of hydrogen from sulfuric acid. So, how many hydrogen atom is displaced by zinc, one atom of zinc in this reaction? That is 2. And that's why the valency of zinc is 2. So, according to the definition that, now let's recall that definition that the valency of an element or a radical, it is the number of hydrogen atom that will combine with or displace one atom of that element or radical. Here, zinc displaces the 2 atoms of hydrogen in this reaction. So, either how many hydrogen atom is displaced by one atom of that element or how many hydrogen atom is attached with one atom of other element. That actually the criteria to determine the valency of an atom. This is the fundamental, because in higher class you will learn the other concept of valency. But I am giving you some other examples. Say sodium chloride, NaCl. Now you see table salt. Here hydrogen is not there, but you can find out the valency of sodium. How? You see that one atom of sodium is attached with one atom of chlorine. And what is the valency of chlorine? 1. So, in that respect, the valency of sodium is 1. You see this example, CuCl2. Now, you see that one atom of chlorine is attached with how many atoms of, one atom of copper is attached with how many atoms of chlorine? 2. And what is the valency of chlorine? 1. So, for one chlorine, the valency is 1. And how many chlorine atoms is there? 2. And that's why in that respect the valency of copper here is 2. Take another example, say ZnO, that is zinc oxide. Okay, now you see here also the hydrogen is not there, but you find out that one atom of zinc, this is zinc oxide, formula of zinc oxide. So one atom of zinc is attached with one atom of oxygen. Now what is the valency of oxygen? 2. And that's why, with that respect, since one atom of zinc is attached with one atom of oxygen, and the valency of one oxygen atom is 2, and that's why in that respect the valency of zinc is 2. And you see the parity. Here the displacement reaction, it shows the valency of zinc 2. And you see this example also in another aspect, another way, you can find out the valency of zinc. Here also it is 2. I am giving you another example that will clear your doubt more. This is sulfuric acid, okay? Now you see, this is the sulfate radical. Now, radical means a group of atoms, or it may be a single atom associated with each other and behaves like a single unit. Now, this is the sulfate radical. Now, consider the sulfate radical, that one sulfate radical is attached with how many atoms of hydrogen? 2. And that's why the valency of sulfate radical is 2. Is it clear? Now, think about this one, say ZnSO4, zinc sulfate, here. Now, you see that one zinc atom is attached with how many sulfate radical? How many sulfate radical is there? 1. One zinc atom attached with one sulfate radical. And what is the valency of the sulfate radical? 2. In that respect, the valency of zinc equal to 2. And you see, here also it shows the valency of zinc 2. Okay. So, this is the way to find out the valency of an element. Now, in some cases, you will find that it exhibits more than one valency. So, that terms at variable valency. For example, SnCl2, stannous chloride. Now you see, one atom of tin is associated with how many chlorine atoms? 2. So the valency of one chlorine atom is 1, and in that respect, the valency of tin is here 2. Now take that example, SnCl4. Now here also, one tin atom is attached with 4 chlorine atoms, and the valency of one chlorine is 1. So here the valency of tin is equal to 4. Now here you see that the particular example, it shows the valency of tin may vary, either it may be 2 or it may be 4. If the lower valency compound is there, it pronounced as us, suffix is us. Stannous chloride, stannic chloride. Take this example, FeCl2, ferrous. Why? Because the valency of chlorine is here 2, because the one atom of iron is attached with 2 chlorine atoms, and the valency of one chlorine is 1, so here the valency of iron is 2. And take that example, ferric chloride, FeCl3. Here the one atom of iron is attached with 3 chlorine atoms, and the valency of one chlorine atom is 1, and that's why here the valency of iron is 3. So here this example also shows that a same element, iron, but it exhibits the two different valencies, one is 2 and one is 3. So this is, since it is the lower valency, so it is termed as us, ferrous chloride, and it is ferric chloride. So there are some examples which exhibits the different kinds of the valencies. And I'm just giving you another example, that the element, that means some elements are there whose valency exhibits 0. That means the helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. This exhibits 0 valency because they are chemically inert. Actually, valency differs the number of electrons present in the outermost of a shell. You know that in an atom, the center, the positive charged particle, protons are present, and the same number of electrons that are revolving around in the different circular or elliptical path around the nucleus. And since the number of protons and the number of electrons are same, that's why the atom is electrically neutral. Now the electrons, these are present in the different shells or orbit. And that is actually determined by some formula. I am not going to discuss about this one right now. But the number of electrons present at the outermost shell, that means the last shell of an atom, that actually determines the valency of an element. Because you will learn later, I will discuss this in another class, that the tendency of an atom to gain the stability, and to gain the stability, it either releases the electron from its outermost orbit, or it accepts one or more electron from other atom in its outermost orbit. Now, how many electrons it releases from its outermost orbit, or how many electrons are present in its outermost shell, or how many electrons it can accept to complete its outermost shell, that actually the main criteria to determine the valency of an element. That is the modern conception. But right now I am not going to discuss this one. You just memorize this one. So today up to this much, and next day we will discuss the next part. Thank you.